Hello and welcome to another video. And today we have a Gigabyte GA-AX370 Gaming K3 on our bench. This came to me for no boot, and if I recall correctly, this doesn't react to the power button, but I'm not too sure what the description actually was, what he meant, because it just said it didn't start up. So let's build this up and see what happens. So we will be using a 2200G in here. So let's see for its passive power consumption. We see 150 milliamps, might be fine. I would expect there's a lot of backlights and similar things on this board. I would expect some of that to be getting active. But nothing yet, maybe as soon as we press the power button. So let's get a speaker onto here and also a power button. And do we have debug LEDs? We do have some in the bottom right corner. So let's see how this board reacts. Let's press the power button. And it does start up. We have CPU, we have DRAM, okay. Okay, I didn't put RAM in here because I didn't expect it to go this far. So let's put RAM into here. Let's try this again and see. So CPU, DRAM. Let's see, do we go for that in DRAM? We're currently stuck on a DRAM LED. And cycling CPU, DRAM. And still cycling CPU and DRAM. Okay, if I see this, there's two main factors that I think. First is a BIOS problem. Second is a problem with any lanes that go to the DRAM. So something on the back where a lane could be damaged. So let's first try to reset this BIOS. Let's see how much voltage this battery has left on here. So the battery has 2.9, which is kind of low. Everything lower than 3, I do not like to see. So let's take it out and find the clear CMOS header on this board. In this case, it is down here, 2 pins. I'm just going to shot with my multimeter probe. Okay, let's see now again after reset BIOS if this is going to react differently. So CPU, DRAM, LED. And let's see if we now, we cycled again DRAM and CPU, and we seem to continue to cycle. Yeah, we continue to cycle. So let's get some, let's get our DDR tester into here. Are we made, let's just swap the slot of DRAM. I haven't done that. That's a very simple thing. Let's see for that. CPU, DRAM. CPU, DRAM. Seems to be the same. Let me quickly go over the other two slots that we have and use some different RAM just to be sure that it isn't a problem with that. So in all of the other slots, we also don't get any startup. And also with different RAM, we do not get startup. So let's get our DDR tester into here for the data lines and see. So the DDR tester is in here and currently all of the LEDs are on except for those that shouldn't be. So let's go into the other channel, and in the other channel it's the same. So it's not a data line problem. So if it's not a data line problem, we will need to check some resistances from like a VREF, for example, and that has high resistance. SPD has high resistance. Clock and data both have very high resistance as far as it seems. Yep, both have very high resistance. So what I would expect is, let's one more thing that I can try without flushing the BIOS is to try a different CPU in here. I don't think that that is going to solve the problem, but let's just try that because it's easy to do that. So instead of the 2200, let's get a 3000G in here. So trying with the 3000G now, and we have the same story with CPU and DRAM LED and then cycling. So next thing what we will need to do is to flush the BIOS. So going through the full process of flushing this BIOS together. This is a very usual chip. This is an MXIC. It is a 2873F. The 73F is basically the important with the 128 in the middle. I think this is a 1.8 volt chip and 128 megabit chip. Megabyte chip, I think. So I always first start with just getting leaded solder on all of the legs, so it's easier to desolder it. So now what I just do is I take my hot air and I hot air this chip off. So right now the BIOS chip is removed, and what I want to try right now is I want to try to boot this board up with only the backup BIOS in place to see if maybe the backup BIOS is still in good condition and we can boot up with that. So we currently have the main BIOS desoldered and only the backup BIOS. Let's see if that is already enough for the board to boot up, because I don't know if it ever accesses the backup BIOS. So let's see, we're going to power it up and let's hit the button. We have CPU, we have RAM, and let's see, it cycles again. Interesting. Okay, so we do have the same behavior with the backup BIOS as far as it seems. So we go to CPU and DRAM also with the backup BIOS. So what we're going to do, we're going to take that chip and we're going to boot it, going to put it onto an adapter that I have. So this is the adapter that I use. This just adapts whatever BIOS chip you have with all of these different footprints. It just adapts that to these 8 pins. And this I will plug in then into my programmer. And that will be then connected via USB to my PC, and we will see us then, and I will show you that done. So let's first put the chip onto this here. So there's one place where that chip belongs to. So let's take our hot air. There's already a lot of flux on there, so I don't need to put new flux on. So the chip is on, and now we have to go over the solder pads. So the area doesn't look nice, but it doesn't have to be. So let's now clean up this area here, get rid of the short that we have there and the short that we have on the other side. And what I now do is I just apply some fresh solder to all of the pads. So the chip is now soldered on. Area doesn't look nice, but it doesn't have to be. And we will put this now into our programmer. So now we are in our programmer software. We're going to put a 1.8 volts and let's see read the identification. And something with my programmer doesn't work. Okay, I might have to reflow this. So we now have the chip recognized right here, and we're going to continue now. So we're going to read the chip out now. So now this is very weird. this chip is basically empty. There's almost nothing on here. Seems like either the reading has gone bad, because there's only content down there and it's very little. This shouldn't be supposed to be like that. Very weird. Okay, just my settings were a little bit wrong. With now having the red chip here, we get some content. This might be an okay BIOS. Normally you would take a backup from this original BIOS that you read, but there's another BIOS chip on there. I don't really think that this is going to be necessary. So what we're going to do is we're going to go on the manufacturer's site now. So now we are on the manufacturer's site, in this case from the Gaming K3. So what we need to go under support, and then down here there's the BIOS. We go up, and I will probably just use the newest BIOS. You need to be careful. You do lose some. Some support for some CPUs, like this Bristol Ridge, for example. You lose here. So now we open up that file. So we open it up. So this is our file that we need. We're going to open it up. So, and if you now see, there's content here. And what we're going to do is write buffer to memory. It's going to be erasing the chip before. So now the chip is programming. And the interesting thing is going to be when it's going to verify, because the verification is the important thing, that it actually verifies, because the verification is the step that I most often got an error, and where it showed that the chip was actually faulty. And now the chip is verifying after programming. So the chip has now been verified without any errors and been programmed. So we now are done with the programming, and what we're going to do now is we're going to be taking the chip off and placing it back on our motherboard. So as you can see, this is our backup chip, and this is our now soldered in chip again. And always pay attention to the polarization. So we have pin 1 right there, marked by this pin here, and also often they have a white dot. And you also can see this arrow right here pointing to this pin, which means this is pin 1. And now our BIOS has changed. Let's turn this on, and let's hit the power button and see what happens. So we have CPU, we have DRAM, we have 3 amps, we have backlights, very, very nice, that's what we want to see. We have cycling to CPU back, and cycle CPU, DRAM, should get the backlight again every second, there it is. And now VGA, and I do not have anything to output right now, so let me turn this off quickly, because it's pausing. Yeah, there's a pause beep from the speaker. Let's turn it off. Let's get something to get a display out of from. So I will be putting a bigger CPU into here. We will be putting a 4100 into here. We're going to put the 2600 into here, because the 4100 might be not supported from the BIOS that I put onto there. So now we put the 2600 into here. We have a GPU, so we can have display output. We have the pause screen on, and let's turn it on. I put all of the RAM into here, all 4 DIMMs, so we can test all of those are also recognized. And there's a pause beep, and we have a BIOS screen. So there's our BIOS screen right now. And what I like now to do is to update the BIOS to the highest version that is available. So currently we are on F53D. I just took the highest version of BIOS. Let me just quickly check that. Yeah, I just updated to the newest BIOS, so forget that. F53 is the newest BIOS from, what is that, the 2nd of September? If that is American. And yeah, that is very nice to see. Now, next thing would be to get an SSD onto here, boot into Windows, put a CMOS battery into here, and then do some stress tests. So now the board is booted into Windows, and important to check is always that the Ethernet and the audio works. And what I will be doing now is also to run some linpack just to run a stress test on here, see that the system is stable. So now the stress test has also completed without any issues. And if this would be my board, I would also flash the backup BIOS. You can do that via the inbuilt BIOS option, the Q-flash. You can also flash the backup BIOS just in case if the main BIOS ever goes bad again, that the backup BIOS is also up to date and working. But I've tested everything. Ethernet is working, USB is working, the audio is working, PCIe is working, the CPU does pass stress tests, all of the RAM is connected. And yeah, everything looks very good on this board. I'm very happy for this repair. This was a usual repair for DRAM, where you check data lines, then you do... You could also check all of the voltages. We didn't do that in this case, because it's very often that we, if you have a CPU DRAM cycle, that it's just a BIOS issue. We've checked with different CPUs and yeah, all of that stuff. But I hope you learned something. I went into detail this time again with the BIOS flashing. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you learned something. All of my tools are linked in the video description. Hope you subscribed if you don't miss any more of my videos. This was MainBot Medic. Thank you very much and goodbye.